you can take out of the showroom. You don't need to buy fancy $3,000, $4,000 option packages to go to the track. Yeah. Others do like that. That's not our plan. If you buy an N car, it's good enough for the track. And for the crazy guys who go really track days like very often, yeah, we developed already some accessories like Pirelli Trofeo Type R, the Trofeo R from Pirelli with lightweight rims. We have special brake pads available for those really where the priority is clearly on track driving. Yeah, the next good thing when we approach with high speed to the corner and go into the corner, turn in, you need a car that is very well planted to the road. And especially here on the Nordschleife, which is a very fast track, there are these two, three areas like Flugplatz or Schwedenkreuz or Schweinschwanz where you want that safe feeling. Yeah, and I mean, we have the most fancy wind tunnel with a rolling road in Namyang, and we have tons of data. But the final decision, how we tune the car and how we make the aerodynamic balance, we decided here on the Nordschleife. And just, it was much more important for us to give that safe driving feeling, especially to those people who are new to the game, who are not so experienced, like the professional drivers or the long year, very experienced journalists. We want that the customers who join this kind of driving and not so experienced can feel comfortable. Even when they make a tourist drive track here, a lap here on the Nordschleife, that in Flugplatz or Schwedenkreuz, that they feel scared and they don't not comfortable with the car. So it's clearly focused on making a good, safe control of the car, even in the high speed, and not so much focusing on the fastest lap time for a professional driver. Then the aero balance would look completely different, but we don't care for that. We developed this clearly for those customers, yeah, that they can fully enjoy this car and not for the lap time. Yeah, I said this before, cooling is a key issue. When you talk aerodynamic, you need to talk cooling. And cooling, same story like with the engine. Priority number one, good dynamic response. That means the best spot for the intercooler is first priority. This is why in our car, the green marked intercooler sits in the most effective spot of the car where the most air pressure come. Just to make sure, even in the hot weather driving, Button Willow in California, that's one of our reference tracks. I mean, of course, now by simulation, we have Button Willow in our test dynos in Namyang. But still, every car goes to Button Willow at some point, just to make sure we can make enough laps in the hot weather and survive without degradation. I mean, every engine, of course, if it's really getting hot, has some degradation in power. Yeah, that is just physics, but we want to avoid the hot mode. And that is a key element why we put a lot of effort in the cooling system. And this is where you make the difference in the end between a real high performance car and a kind of pretender, yeah, which is only like for two laps or so. Because we know the guys who buy these cars, they go out there on a track day, but if after two, three laps the fun is over, I mean, then this is not an enjoyable car for those high-performance customers. So this is where we put a lot of effort. Then the next thing, you're going into the corner, the transition. I mean, I keep saying the body in white structure, that is the most important chassis part. And that is a good thing. We are working based on a Hyundai car. And all our Hyundai cars, they have very good, strong body in white structures. They are not necessarily the lightest body in white structures, but they are pretty much with the best. And I don't care for like 10, 15 kilogram more in the body in white, but it's a very good basis to make a high performance car. We only needed very few little enhancements to the body in white. As you can see here in the floor pan, we added some framework to stiffen up a little bit. Locally we did something, but with the normal tires, it's almost not necessary to do this. But like I said before, we also tested with very sticky cup tires, we tested with slicks, and then these things matter more. And this is why we put it in there, because we know the guys will put the different sticky tires to the car, and then these things matter. Yeah, and so it's a already pretty good car, but thinking about what our customers will do with this car. And we see already many i30 N customers here in the tourist driving on the Nürburgring on the weekend. So I think it's all the right way to make this, yeah, even for those cup tires or even slick tires. Then, of course, cornering, turn-in, transition, I mean, the front axle, rear axle, that's the key element. We call our axle and power sense axle. And we call it power sense because we accepted that there is a certain level of torque steer in the car that gives us also some feedback of what's going on wheel side. And we think we found a very acceptable level of torque steer, but also that helped us to achieve a good level of feedback from what's going on wheel side. And the interaction with our car is very intense. So there are other cars out there. They might have maybe more sophisticated axle designs, yeah, with Revo knuckles and whatever. But I mean, even with all that extra effort, I mean, it's more expensive, it's heavier, and still it's not perfect. And ours also is not perfect. But I think the overall balance, and with the power level we have in our car, I think this is the right way to go. And when you drive the cars later on, you can, yeah, make up your own opinion about this. So, and to have a high level of mechanical grip, so we increased the roll center in the front compared from the base car. The whole front axle is completely, everything is new. Cross member, we have the belt-driven, rack-mounted motor for the steering. So it's very stiff, very powerful design. So there's no stiffening up of the steering, even in the funny sections here, like Fuchsröhre or Flugplatz or so. You cannot bring this car to heavy steering. In the beginning, of course, we had all these issues when we started the development. But even with slicks, you can't get the car to that point. So it's all well taken care of. Yeah, and then, yeah, the whole kinematics layout also is done in a way. It was always around balance in between feedback, yeah, torque steer, and how to make this really fun to drive. Especially then in combination with a limited slip differential. So we have a very stiff design, so camber stiffness is pretty high, so higher than on some competitors, which is, yeah, the basic for, yeah, good cornering control and driving precision. So on the rear axle, we took the roll center a little bit down, so with the whole roll axle, we changed like into this way for mechanical grip and good roll behavior and dynamic driving. So other than that, I mean, it's our multi-link rear axle design. There is not too many changes on the rear. Of course, springs, dampers, and so on, we changed. One key element is to make the car very lively, that it turns easily. So the toe control, when the under compression or rebound, that is an element where we worked a lot to make the car really tail happy and fun to drive and agile. So, and I guess you can feel later on how much fun it is. There's many nice corners and you can try the throttle off and how nicely the car helps you to make the turn. Yeah.